Hello, I'm Sarah from InkNow. In this video today, I'm here to share with you 10 different tips to increase your productivity when you're using PowerPoint. For all the latest tips and tricks on using tech in your classroom, hit subscribe. All right, let's get started with productivity tip number one, taking advantage of creating your own PowerPoint template. Templates are handy to use so that you have consistent pre-designed PowerPoint presentations ready to go. PowerPoint has a variety of themes and templates readily available to you when you open up the application. However, you can also create your own. For this example, I'm going to go with one that they already have available to us. So you can take a look at all that they offer and click on one that looks nice and click Create. Once the file opens up, you can go about personalizing your presentation. So one of the things we can do is change the theme color of your deck, along with adding a title. So let's say I'm going to be using this slide deck for a review lesson before a big quiz for my students. So I can add that title, and I can also add a couple more slides and put their main title on them because I know they're going to stay the same throughout all of these PowerPoint presentations. Once you've completed all the changes that you want, you can go up to File and Save As, and then you can save it onto your PC. And instead of saving it as a PowerPoint presentation, you'll want to save it as a PowerPoint template. And now when you go to open this, you'll already have some of your slides pre-designed for you. Tip number two is the Slide Master template. So this tip differs from tip number one because it's a template just for one particular PowerPoint presentation. So instead of copying and pasting something on every single one of your PowerPoint slides, you can use this to save yourself plenty of repetitive actions. So I have another example file pulled up here, and to have access to the Slide Master template, you can go up to the View tab. Then you can click on the Slide Master, and you'll see a template for all the different kinds of layouts in PowerPoint. And if you scroll up to the Way tab, you can click on the Full Master View. So you can add in any text or images that you want to appear on every single one of your slides. So I'm going to go ahead and insert our InkNow EDU logo. And then I can move it around and you'll see that it appears in the same spot on all of the slides. So if you have a school logo or any quotes or anything you want to have on every single slide, this is the best way to do it. You'll notice that the InkNow EDU logo image that I added has a gray background, so it's not transparent, but my slide background is still white. To format my slide background to be the exact shade of gray that is in my image, I can go on to tip number three, which is using the eyedropper. So the eyedropper will exactly match any colors on any text or images that you have on your slide. So to make these changes, I can go up to Background Styles and click on Format Background. Then I can go over to Color and click on the eyedropper, and then you just hover over the color that you want your slide to be. And just click and it will make the changes for you. Since I'm still in the Slide Master template, it's changed all my slides. So if I close this view, we can see that it has made all the changes on my slides. You can also use the eyedropper to change font color in the same way. So I can quickly change the font color of my title. I just go to the font color, click on eyedropper, and let's change it to the color in the logo. And there you go, it has changed the color. So it's a super easy way to exactly match any color that you want. If you're struggling with your creativity when making your presentation, you can rely on PowerPoint's Design Ideas tool. This tool can completely upgrade your presentation by giving it a complete design makeover. To have access to this tool, you must be an Office 365 user though. If you are an Office 365 user, you can access Design Ideas by going to the Design tab and clicking on Design Ideas. Then the side panel will open up and you can scroll through and choose which design looks the best to you. Tip number five is to use keyboard shortcuts. Keyboard shortcuts are one of the easiest ways to boost your productivity. There are many, many different shortcuts to use in PowerPoint. However, while you're in the process of creating your presentation, here are two that you should definitely be using. The first one is Control Drag to copy any image easily. So we can go to this slide here, and I want to copy this arrow over to show that it's parallel. So I can just click Control and drag, and the arrow is copied. The second one is to use the Shift key to make perfect shapes. So on my last slide here, I want to add in a square, so I can go over to Insert and click on square. And so if I don't use the Shift key, I just kind of have to guess and see if it will make a perfect square. However, if now this time I hold down the Shift key, it will perfectly create a perfect square. You can also use this for circles, triangles, or diamonds. Tip number six is for aligning objects quickly and easily. If there are many different objects on your slide, like photos or text, and you want everything to be lined up properly and looking nice, you can easily do so with the Align tool. So on this slide here, I'm going to hold down the Shift key while I click on the images that I'm going to align. So I can either go to Align through the Arrange tab, or on the Format tab up here, I can click on the Align tool. And then you can choose to align left, right, center, or top, middle, bottom. Since all these images are different sizes, I'm going to do middle. And then in addition, you can choose to distribute them horizontally or vertically, so that this way there's even space between each of the images. So with just a couple of clicks, you have everything looking nice and orderly. Tip number seven is to group different objects on your PowerPoint slides together. You can choose to group images, text, or a mix of the two together. This comes in handy when you have formatting changes to make to many different objects at once, or if you want to move a whole bunch of different objects on your slide all at once. So for this example, I'm going to group these three different text boxes. So I hold down the Shift key and then right click and click Group. Now you'll see that all of the text boxes are together as one and they can be moved around the slide. You can also make any formatting changes, so I can change the color of the text along with making it bigger or smaller. If you ever need to ungroup these boxes, you can just left click again and click group and ungroup. The Format Painter is one of the best productivity tips. With the Format Painter, you can easily copy any format from a piece of text or an image onto another piece of text or image. So to do this, I'm going to go up to this slide here, and you just need to highlight the text that you're going to want to copy the format of. Then you can click on the Format Painter up in the clipboard section, and then you just have to highlight the text that you're going to want to paste that format onto. To copy the format onto multiple items at once, you can double click on the Format Painter. And then you can just highlight in the same way, but you don't have to click back on the Format Painter each time. There's also a keyboard shortcut for the Format Painter that is very useful. So to use the keyboard shortcut, you can click on an object that you want to copy and click Ctrl+Shift+C. And then to paste that format, you can click on the object and click Ctrl+Shift+V. Moving on to tip number nine, which is reusing slides. If there is a slide from a previous presentation that will work well in your current slide deck, you can easily insert it into this presentation. So to do so, we can just go up to the New Slide button and click for the drop-down menu to click on Reuse Slides. The side panel will open up and you can browse for the presentation of your choice. Once it's opened up, you'll see all of the slides appear in the side panel. Then if you click on the slide that you want, it will insert it into your current presentation with the matching theme and formatting. Lastly, tip number 10 is the Quick Access Toolbar. This toolbar in the left-hand corner is available to you no matter which tab is open on the PowerPoint ribbon. So you can actually customize this to have icons and tools that you use very frequently. So you can add in a quick print button if you print often, or you can take a look at the many other commands that PowerPoint offers. So if there's a tool or a button that you use very often, you can add it on to this toolbar so that you have access to it at any time. And those are the 10 tips that I have that you can start using to boost up your productivity in PowerPoint. Let me know if you use any others. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you learned something new. See you next time.